What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here with another FCPO Tech Tip. Today, we're talking motive bleeders. In front of us, we have two red label kits, and what that means is these come with a 3-foot hose as well as a black plastic cap, which is crimped onto the hose directly. You can upgrade to a black label unit, which comes with an anodized cap. This allows it to spin without spinning the hose, which is a nice feature. And if it's something that you're gonna be doing quite often, I would highly recommend. Otherwise, the red label kit is gonna be perfect. This tool is great for bleeding the vehicle's hydraulic system by yourself. You no longer need a second person in the car to pump that brake pedal and or the clutch pedal if your reservoir is all in one for both systems. So it's pretty handy. It has a gauge that allows you to regulate the level of pressure. And Motive recommends about 15 PSI, which we'll show you in just a moment. You can go a little bit over. I wouldn't really recommend anything under. That is about the sweet spot to get the fluid flowing. This is also a great tool that allows you to pressurize the system if you have a feeling that you have a leak or you want to track down a leak. You can pressurize the system without adding any fluid to the system. That way, should you have a leak, you're not running more fluid through the system, just wasting brake fluid. A couple things to note, there are some accessories you may want to get when considering a motive brake bleeder, and that is going to be your motive bleeder catch cans. These clip onto the nipples on your brake calipers and will catch the fluid. They have a nice little metal rope that you can use to hang them while you're allowing the system to do its thing. Other thing to keep in mind is you will need brake fluid. These hold about 2 liters of brake fluid in total, which is more than enough to flush a typical car's brake system. And of course, a flared wrench of your choice to undo your brake bleeder valves. That's pretty much where you're gonna need to get started. So why don't we go ahead and hop over to the X1 behind me where we'll show you how to use the tool, how to set it up, and go from there. First things first, it's gonna be locating your brake master cylinder reservoir on your vehicle. On this X1, it is hidden underneath this cover in the cowl. Once you have that, you're always gonna wanna go ahead and remove the cap. Set a little towel or something next to it so that you can set the cap on it. You can undo, in the case of this vehicle, the electrical connector if you wish to remove the cap in full, which we can do here just to unclutter our work area. Go ahead and set that to the side. Next, what you're going to want to do with your new motive power bleeder is once you have joined the two lines together, whatever adapter you choose to run to your bottle, you'll want to make sure that your gasket is sitting in place as well. That comes included with the kit. We're going to go ahead and thread this on with the reservoir empty. This is just going to be so that we can check the system for leaks as well as our tool for any leaks. Last thing we want to do is waste a bunch of brake fluid. Screw the cap on nice and tight to your reservoir. We're going to go ahead and set our reservoir or set our tool down on top of this air box and keep some towel in case there's any spillage. And what we're going to do now is we're going to pump the system to 15 PSI. That's what Motive recommends whenever bleeding a vehicle system. There are times when you may want to go above the 15, depending on the type of vehicle you're working on. All right, and now our goal is simply gonna be to give the tool a few minutes and give the vehicle a few minutes. In this case, we're not seeing the pressure drop. We're not seeing it drop drastically. So we know that the tool has no leaks, and we also know that the vehicle has no leaks. So we'll give it about a minute or two, we'll come back, and as long as that is holding, then we can go ahead and proceed by filling the motive bleeder with fluid.
A few minutes later.
We've given the system a few minutes, nothing has dropped, so we know that the tool is good, and we know that the vehicle is good. Next, we're going to work on releasing the pressure so that we can fill our motive bleeder. This is also super important to note when the system is actually filled with fluid and you're done bleeding, that you always release the pressure at the bleeder and not at the reservoir. Otherwise, you're going to cause a geyser of brake fluid over there, and the last thing you want is brake fluid all over your vehicle. All right. Go ahead and take this cap off, set it to the side. Make sure there's no debris or anything floating around in your reservoir before you get started. Make sure that sealing ring is on the top here on your pump. For this demonstration, we're going to be using our Lucamoli.4 fluid. We run this in most of our project cars here at the shop. And if we're working on a race car like Golden Era over there, we'll use the racing fluid. We're gonna fill the system with 1,000 milliliters of brake fluid. That should be more than enough to flush the system on this X1. You can add up to a full 2 liters on the motive system if you're doing a maybe a larger car with longer brake lines or something of that sort. Or if you have a really dirty system and you really, really want to flush it out, you can always add more fluid than the 1,000 milliliters that we're doing here. Be careful not to get brake fluid on any painted surface or your skin. This stuff is nasty and it will damage your paint. Now with that, we can go ahead and reinstall our pump. One thing to note about these units is once you're done bleeding out the system, you basically want to recycle whatever brake fluid is left in the motive bleeder. Brake fluid, as you know, loves to absorb moisture. And if you have one of these sitting on the shelf for a long time with brake fluid in it, that brake fluid is going to go bad. So you may as well dispose of it properly, recycle it, and leave this clean for the next time you're going to use it. With our cap on and fully situated, now we can go ahead and pressurize the system to 15 once more on the gauge here. Just for insurance, we're going to give that a few minutes again to hold, make sure we have no leaks anywhere, and then we'll pick it right back up. So now, my good people, at this point, your motive bleeder is filled with fluid. Everything's holding nice and tight. You're at about 15 on your gauge. The next step is going to be to actually bleed the system. And this is what's so great about this tool. You can do this by yourself. There's nobody needed inside of the vehicle. We're going to take our catch bottle. I'm going to take our flared wrench and we're going to head to the right rear corner of the X1. Now, a pretty good rule of thumb is always going to be to work furthest away from the reservoir and work your way closer, meaning the right rear corner of the X1 is going to be the caliper that's furthest away. From there, we will proceed to the rear left, then the front right, and then the front left. Some vehicles may be different, so just be sure to check your repair manual before you do so, but for the most part, rear right, work your way over, is going to be the way on these cars. Another thing to note is every time you do one brake caliper at a time, you're going to lose a bit of pressure. So just come back to the bleeder here and pump it back up to 15 because you are going to lose pressure as we get fluid in our catch bottles. So with that, let's head over to the rear right and start bleeding the system. All right, my good people, we are over at the right rear corner of the X1. You can see I'm using the metal cable along with a lug bolt, and I'm just draping it over the heat shield here to hang our bottle. You don't want to put too much stress on this hose while the system is bleeding. Sometimes it can kink over at the bleeder valve and make it look like you have air in the system when you actually don't. So just a little tips and tricks that'll make your life a little bit easier when you're bleeding by yourself. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take our flared wrench and seat it over our bleeder valve. Then we'll take our hose, feed that over, crack it open, and allow it to bleed. With our bleeder valve open, we can see the fluid that's coming through our hose, and it's looking a lot better than what we started off with. You can see the fluid in here is pretty dark, and it looks like it may have been dyed, or the tool that was used last time this was done was a bit dyed, as it looks a bit blue. But two things we want to keep in mind. We want to make sure that the level doesn't drop below 10 on our gauge. If it does, pump it back up to 15. And two, we don't want the bleeder to run dry, otherwise we're going to introduce air back into the system. So just keep those two things in mind while you're allowing this to bleed. Once you're happy with the fluid coming through the hose into the catch bottle, go ahead and close your bleeder valve. Don't over tighten it. Pull the hose off in a manner where it's going to pull down, so any fluid that is right here will drop into the hose instead of onto the ground or over your bleeder valve. And just pick the hose up. Let it drain slowly back into the catch bottle. And now from there, we're just going to go ahead and repeat the process on the rear left, then the front right, and then the front left, and then we'll catch you back up front at the motive bleeder. My good people, at this point, the car's back on the ground. All the wheels are on and torqued up. You can see we still have a lot of pressure at the reservoir here. I kept going around every corner and pumping it back up. The most important step here to avoid making a mess and getting brake fluid everywhere is to break the pressure at the bleeder itself, not at the reservoir. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and open this slowly so that pressure drops all the way to zero. Now with that, we can take our cap off. And then with that, you can see our fluid level is almost perfect. It's almost at the max line. If you need to, you can always go ahead and take a little bit out using a syringe tool. In this case, we're going to use a small extractor just to get it to that max line as best as possible. Then with that, you can reinstall your cap once more. Put your cover back on. And with that, my good people, that is going to conclude how to use a motive bleeder, a really awesome one-person tool. Again, can't stress that enough. If you like this product, please be sure to check that and many more out, available on fcpo.com. If you like this tech tip, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on this tool specifically or how we used it today, leave that in the comment section below. And if you want to see more tech tips like this, please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.